So in this particular computer aided engineering graphics subject, we sketch and then we draft. For the drafting, we are using solid edge V19 or solid edge velocity series software. So now I am going to give you a overview about the particular software, and also I will explain you how this software is used to draw the sketches in the computer. Okay. So once you run this particular software, you will get this particular window on your desktop or on your computer, in your laptop. Okay. So there are 5 different possibilities to create a solid part using this software. You can create a sheet metal part, you can weldment, assembly all the parts which you have created, and then you can obtain the drawings. But right now we are not going to use these 4 options. We are going to use only the drawing, that is to draw the sketches. This drawing mode will help us. So click on drawing. So as you click on drawing, you will get this particular atmosphere. This is the sketching area in which you can able to see a sheet, and there are some different toolbars. Let us first focus on all these toolbars. Okay. These 4 or 5 toolbars what you have, you can drag them down, this you cannot drag. Okay. So first one, important one, is main. So keep the main toolbar here. Okay. If it is already there, no issues. Then we can use drawing toolbar, so drag it here, you keep it vertical. Okay. This is a drawing toolbar, this is a main toolbar. Then other one is the drawing views toolbar, that also you keep here. This toolbar is not required, relationship toolbar is right now not required, just close it. Whenever you want, you can go to view and you can add the toolbars whenever you require. Okay. So this is the introduction about the toolbar. This is the first setup you need to do when you start with the particular software to work. Okay. Then we shall go for the size of the sheet. Okay. So file, click on file menu, left click on file menu, and then go to sheet setup. Okay. So sheet setup will give you a particular window in which there are 3 options: size, name and background. Okay. Right now you can see in the background the size of the sheet is A2, or in the size also you can see it is A2 wide. So what you are supposed to do is click on background and change to A4 sheet, because all our problems are could be solved on A4 sheet. So just change the background, easy to change because there are only 4 backgrounds. Change the A4 sheet, click on size, automatically size is also changed to A4. Okay. Then click on save defaults option. Okay. Save defaults option, why I will tell you later. Okay. Then click on OK. Fine. Now in the screen you can see a small portion is zoomed there. So you can go to fit. There is a command called FIT fit, the zoom fit. Once you click on this, the entire screen will get you the sheet. Okay. Now something is written over here. Okay. So that is the background. Okay. So in the file sheet setup, you had seen there is a sheet size. This is sheet size, okay, on which we work, and there is a background. Okay. This is the background. So both are visible here. There is a sheet and there is a background. But here you see, you can observe only sheet 1. Okay. You do not observe any backgrounds. To view them, you go to view and click on background sheet. Now you can see A4, A3, A2 and A4 sheets. Okay. A1, A2, A3 and A4 sheet. Okay. So all the 4 sheets are available. Suppose these are already displayed, you need not go to view and click on this. Now you can see there is a tick mark here. It says that all the 4 sheets are being visible to the user. Okay. Now click on A4 sheet, because our sheet is of A4 size. Click on A4 sheet background. This is the background. Now you can see here background, written background, but in sheet 1 nothing is written here. Okay. This is the background. So go here, you can say fit here for the background also, and select everything. Now how do we select all this? There is something called window selection. Window selection means take the cursor, and this is the cursor, press the left button of the mouse and drag the mouse, press hold the left button and drag the mouse. Whatever comes inside the selection window will be selected. Okay. Then you can, once you selected that, you go to the delete command of the keyboard and delete. Press delete, it will be deleted. Similarly, you select all these again by the window selection and press delete command. Okay. Now the background is empty, not the sheet. Please try to understand, this is only the background. So, why background is required? So, what I am doing is, I am going to text command. I can change the font of the text, size of the text, say 5, and I write my name here. I write my name here. I go to select tool and I can change the position of the text wherever I want, okay, by dragging it. Okay. So, I wrote my name in the background. Now, I am coming back to sheet 1. Now, I can see in the sheet 1, this is displayed. So, whatever I write in the background will automatically come in the sheet 1. Not only that, when you add a new sheet, so how to add a new sheet? Take the cursor on sheet 1, press the right button and say insert. Okay. Go to the sheet 1, press the right button of the mouse and click on insert. So, it will give us another sheet, that is sheet number 2. And in the sheet 2 also, my name is already shown. So, the advantage of writing something on the background is, it will now again I can write now also. I write projection of points, that is the name of the chapter or the unit, and I can place it somewhere wherever convenient for me. Okay, projection of points. Now, come back to sheet 1, it is there. Go to sheet 2, it is there. So, whatever I write on the background sheet, it will be displayed on the sheet 1 and sheet 2. Okay. Sheet 1, sheet 2 or so on, sheet 3, sheet 4 are used to solve the problems. Okay. Now, let us look at the other options. Next, so I had told you so far the arrangement of the toolbars and changing the size. Now, I will check the size of the sheet 2. How shall I check the size of the sheet 2? Click on sheet 2 and go to file and file properties, or sorry, sheet setup. It is already A4 sheet background and the size is already A4. How does it happen? When I open the file and I check the size of sheet 1, it was A2. Since I clicked on save defaults, means the default I changed to A4 and then I clicked on save defaults, it says that the default has been changed to A4. That is why even though you add any number of new sheets, sheet 3, you can see the size is A4 wide and the background is A4. So, the default has been set to A4. So, that is the advantage of like changing the default. Okay. Now, coming back to sheet 1. Okay. So, to draw something, let us solve a problem on points here. So, you need to know few more things. First thing is, there is something called maintain relationships. Okay. So, now there is a tick mark here, it says that maintain relationship is on. Now, I will just switch off that. Once I will click on that, it will the tick mark will disappear. It means maintain relationship is off. Now, I will try to draw a rectangle. Okay. Now, I will keep maintain relationship on. I will go to tools and click on maintain relationships. Now, you can see the tick mark is there. Again, I go for line command. I draw a rectangle. Okay. Both rectangles I will dimension. There is a command called smart dimension. I will dimension this. Okay. Now, I will try to change the dimension. So, it is 59.51, I change it to 70, okay. It will change. How does it change? You just observe it. This I change it to say 72, I change it to say 70, enter. How it is changing? Or I change it to 65, okay. So, in this drawing you check, this I am going to change to 70, okay. This I am going to change to 65. Okay. So, you can see the difference. If maintain relationship is not on, these relationships are not maintained. So, relationships to be maintained are the size or the connection between the two lines. Now, you can check the size, it is perfectly 70 by 65, but here 70 by 65 is only two lines. Other two lines are not able to maintain the relationship, but when it was created, it was a rectangle and the opposite sides were equal and parallel, but now after changing the dimension, the relationships are not like followed or maintained. So please remember, whenever you work on this particular software, always maintain relationship should be on. So before you work, before you start working, see that it is on or off. Next one is IntelliSketch. You click on IntelliSketch, you can see auto dimension, and auto dimension mean if you click keep it on and if you draw a line, the dimension is automatically drawn. Okay, so hence it is not required, actually not suggested. So go to tools, IntelliSketch, and switch off that. Okay, auto dimension not required. By default it will not be. Suppose somebody keeps it on, it will be on later on. Okay, then go to relationships. There are so many relations are given here. So right now, for first unit, the important one are only four relationships. Those are endpoint, point on element, horizontal vertical, and intersection point. Only keep only four relationships on. Right now they are sufficient. Now what are they? I will tell you. First I'll tell you what is horizontal or vertical. When you take a line command and start drawing the line command, you can see there is a horizontal line following the cursor. Okay. If I take like this, now this line is not horizontal, it is an inclined line, then the symbol disappears. When you take the cursor in such a way that the line drawn is horizontal, then that symbol will be like appeared. So that symbol will like make us sure that the line is perfectly horizontal. Okay. This is how I could draw a perfectly horizontal line. So that relationship will help us that whichever line I am drawing is horizontal, perfectly horizontal or not. So this horizontal and vertical relationship will help us to draw xy and x1 y1 line. Okay. And now the remaining ones. So remaining ones are point on element, intersection point, and end point. Okay, end point, point on element, intersection point. So what do you mean by end point? Suppose I wanted to draw a line or start a line exactly from this end point. So this relationship will help me. Or I wanted to complete the line in at the another end point of the line, this will help me. This is how the end point relationship will help me to draw line exactly from the end point. But now I wanted to draw it from a intersection point. So there are two lines here, horizontal and vertical. So there is an intersection point here. So this will help me, intersection relationship will help me to draw a line from this point. So I wanted to connect anywhere here, this relationship will help me. Okay. Anywhere means it is any point on the line. So this says point on element. So there are several points on this element. You can click it to any point. Okay. Any point here, any point here, any point on this line, any point on this line, but sure that it is on that line, but anywhere. Okay, anywhere on the line. If I click here, it won't come. Only if you keep the cursor on the line, then only it will be displayed. Okay, so that is the advantage. Okay, I can now, you will get end point here, because there is an end point of the line, you will get an end point here. Okay, or point on element or end point. So whichever relationship you pick, so from there or to that particular point, the line will be drawn. Okay. So that is the importance of IntelliSketch relationships. For the first unit, this is this many relationships are sufficient. Okay. Now let us go to solve a problem. So before you solve the problem, what all things you need to do? Set up the toolbars, set up the sheet size. Okay. So sheet size should be A4. Okay. And keep the save defaults on, and then go to background A4 sheet. Whatever text you wanted to add there, you write down there, and then come back to sheet 1. And as you come back, the sheet size is proper, background is filled, and these two things are very important. Okay. Maintain relationship must be on, and in the IntelliSketch, these four relationships must be on. Now you are ready to draft for the particular problem. Now let us solve one particular problem for which I need to draw XY line. Okay, let me solve problem number 3, in which we had all the 3 views. Okay, so let me draw first XY line, because for all the point problem we need to draw start with the XY line. So I start with the line command, and as I click on line command, you can see the properties of the lines are displayed on the toolbar. First one is color, we are not going to change it. Next one is the type of the line, whether continuous, hidden or axis, definitely it is a continuous line, and the thickness. This is the important thing. Enter the value for the line thickness. So, for this it is 0.15. 0.15 mm is the thickness for the XY line, you need to remember. Okay. So, I have entered the value of thickness as 0.15. Now, bring the cursor somewhere here and press left button of your mouse, then drag the mouse. Okay. Drag the mouse. Now, the horizontal symbol must be displayed there, so that XY line is perfectly horizontal. Press again the left button. Okay. Still it is continuing the line command, but we do not want to continue. Press the right button of the keyboard. So, take the line command. Once again I repeat, take line command, take the like proper 0.15 thickness, then press the left button of the mouse and leave the button, and press the left button again, drawing the horizontal line, and press the right button. Okay. So, then create a text. So, to create a text, you need to click on this particular tool and change the font if you want. Already it has been done earlier, so it is there already. So, 5 mm, click the cursor here and press X, click the cursor here, press Y, click the cursor here and type VP and HP. Okay. So, XY VP HP representation already drawn. Now, let us go to the problem. It is problem number 3 from the question bank. It says that draw all the 3 views of the point P lying 60 mm below SP, 50 mm in front of VP and 40 mm from RPP. Also state the quadrant in which it lies. Just now we have solved it. It is below SP and in front of VP. So, it is fourth quadrant. So, in the fourth quadrant, both VP SP will fall below the XY line. Okay. So, I need to make some changes here. So, anytime you can see, drag the line, go to like select mode, select the line and drag wherever you want. So, I will move little above, I can drag the text also wherever I want. Okay. So, I will drag the text, this you can do anytime, once it is created you can do it anytime. So, keep the cursor, take the cursor near, it will highlight the border, click on the border and move it. Okay. So, this is the space requirement for the problem. Now, go to line command again. Now, I wanted to draw a projection line. Earlier, I had drawn the XY line, the thickness was 0.15. Now, I am drawing a projection line to obtain the distances from XY. So, it is 45 mm above HP and 60 mm below HP and 50 mm in front of VP. So, first I go for 50 mm in front of VP. So, I need to change the thickness of the line. So, thickness of the line is here 0.05. 0.05 is the thickness we use for projection lines. Okay. So, and also before that, I am sorry, I need to draw the x1, y1 line here, because this is a problem in which you have 3 views and it is given as RPP. So, let me draw the x1, y1 line here, draw x1, y1 line and name it x1 and y1. Okay. Now, because I have to follow or I have to keep a distance of 40 mm from RPP. So, this is our RPP. Okay. From here, I need to maintain a distance of 40 mm. So, how shall I do that? There is a command called offset. Okay. This offset command will help us to do that. But anyway, no issues. What I will do is, there are so many methods. The other method is, I just draw a line. I take thickness as 0.05 and I will draw a line from any point on this line to downward for a distance 50 mm. As you start with the line command, it will ask length and angle always. Okay. So, length is 50 mm, 50, enter from the keyboard. So, 50 is freeze now. You can able to draw a 50 mm line in any angle, but what we need is, we need a line down XY, perpendicular to XY downward. Okay. So, vertical symbol is on, I click the left button of the mouse. Okay. This is a 50 mm line. Now, what I am doing is, I go for distance between command. These are the dimension commands. Go to distance between command, select this particular line by pressing left button. Press the left button to select this particular line and it is giving us a vertical distance between the two line, horizontal distance, and that has to be 40. So, enter 40. Okay. Automatically, I got it. If you check the smart dimension of this line, it is 50. Okay. So, easily you can obtain a line at a distance 40 mm and 50 mm from this. So, add one more line here from this end point, because it is 60 mm below SP, go for a length 10 mm, 10 and enter and draw a line downward, press right button. Okay. And now you can check the distance between this line and this end point is 60 mm, because I cannot go for smart dimension here, because I have drawn a 10 mm line here. So, that 60 mm dimension can be drawn only if you go for distance between this line and the end point, will give us 60 mm. Now, I have to draw the front and top views. So, there is a command called point here, click on point, click on thickness, the thickness of the point must be 2 mm, okay. Thickness of the point must be 2 mm. So, come here, when the end point is displayed, click the left button, click the left button. So, one is top view, one is front view. Let us decide which is top view, which is front view. Read the problem again, 60 mm below SP. So, it is the SP distance, so SP distance meant for front view. So, name P dash here, point name is P. So, name P dash and this is P, okay. This is the top view, this is the front view. Now, to obtain the side view, again go to line command, go to thickness 0.05, because projection line having thickness 0.05. Now, this 45 degree line has to be drawn from the intersection of these two. So, move the cursor over both the lines, you will get an intersection there, okay, relationship. Start from there, and the direction downward is treated as minus 45. So, enter minus 45 as the angle here, do not enter any length value, enter only minus 45, press the enter button of the keyboard, it is locked, then draw a lengthy line, okay, press the right button. Now, you can cross verify whether the angle is proper or not, go to angle between dimension, click this line and click this line, you can get the dimension which is perfectly 45.00, okay. So, this is how. Now, go to line command again, the thickness is like by default 0.05, which you have used for the previous line, okay. Now, I suppose to project the front view horizontally and the top view from this point to this point, that is P, the top view should be projected horizontally on the 45 degree line, okay. So, the particular relationship says that is point on element and horizontal. Point on element means I am exactly on the 45 degree line, horizontal is the line is perfectly horizontal. Click the left button, then move down, okay. It can be extended further, no problem. The intersection of these two lines gives us the side view. Go to point, change the thickness to 2 mm, press the enter button, so that the value will be registered or confirmed. Then come here and click on the intersection point of the two lines. So, that will give us P double dash, the side view of the particular point. So, this completes the solution of problem number 3. So, once again let us revise quickly. So, what you supposed to do when you open with the, now you can save the file, click on save, and wherever you want you can save this, okay. Just go to browse and you can select any like directory and whichever folder you wanted to like save, you can save it, okay. So, quickly revise, when you open the drawing file, you need to do the arrangement of the toolbars, then check the size of the sheet by going to sheet setup by this way, right clicking on sheet 1, or you can go to file sheet setup and click on the background and change the background to A4 sheet, and you can check the A4 sheet, then click on save defaults, then save OK. So, this is the first thing you need to do, then go to tools and check whether maintain relationship is on or off, it should be on always. Go to IntelliSketch, 4 relationships you have to keep on, which I have already told mentioned. Then you can come to like directly, or before that you can go to background and put the text whichever you want, they will be automatically coming on the particular sheet 1 as well as sheet 2 as well as sheet 3, okay. So, you can start with the working. So, take line command and the thickness you are taking for the xy line is 0.15. So, 3 different thicknesses we have used here, for the xy line we have used 0.15. These projection lines are drawn with, all these projection lines are drawn with 0.05, and the points are drawn with the thickness 2 mm. If I zoom this, anytime you can zoom, this is the command called zoom area, you can zoom any area, you can see here 2 mm point has been drawn here, okay. To go back, click on fit, Okay, fit will give us the entire like window of the sheet. Okay, so you can draw lines and you can draw front view, top view and the side view from the particular problem. Thank you.